Welcome you two. This is Timothy D.
And this is Firecat 91.
We're here for you today because
we're a bunch of race!
Race Spyro the Dragon!
Awesome!
Let's do this. Alright, so first up, let's go to the options. Options. It's not working. Oh duh. Let's see. Click on this. This screen right here? Okay. Options!
There we go.
And we're gonna set our options. I'm more of an active player. I don't know what Firecat is up to.
I leave it on passive.
Passive, okay. Done and done. Okay.
Ready?
So, here's the thing. We're gonna race from the start to Ganassi's treasure.
Yeah.
Alright. So we're pretty much going to complete the entire game. Whoever goes and race to the finish wins.
So, you ready for this?
Alright, let's do this. 3, charge. 2, 1, charge!
I really hate that you can skip this one.
Dang, I was trying to skip too. Stop talking.
Find dragons.
Alright, now let's do this. Win!
Where are you?
I am not doing very good. Get over here.
Come back here.
Where's that other one at? Just kill these two.
Now, I actually let's played this. This was my first let's play ever. I did this about 3 or 4 years ago.
And I myself, I believe I did this about a year ago. I let's play both this game, Spyro 2 with those range, and Spyro 3.
I believe it's called Gateway to Glimmer in Europe.
Yeah, I think that's what it's called.
Yeah, Spyro 2 is called Gateway to Glimmer.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know about anyone else, but I always like to start with the flights.
Huh. I always like to start off with collecting everything first and then go into the flight.
Yeah.
Not sure that's a good idea though, because I'm not doing very good right now. Keep missing everything. And I have a lousy controller. Not good.
Well, the flights can be kind of tricky. You know, call me a daredevil. You know, I often tell my viewers, you know, not to do what I'm doing. Because I can be pretty reckless.
I can see that now.
Yeah, the flights can be pretty darn tricky. My least favorite one is Crystal Flight.
I kind of like that one.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I didn't like the second one. I forgot what that one's called.
That's Night Flight, that's the Peacekeeper one.
Yeah, I kind of failed on that on my playthrough quite a bit of times. If anybody has seen that, then you know where to go.
My favorite level is the one everyone absolutely hates. It's Treetops.
Of course.
Can't wait to get to that one.
I can't believe you like that one.
I love that one!
Can't stand it sometimes. But if all goes well, I'll do really good in that one.
And I'll probably fail because I keep talking.
Yeah, keep talking. Yeah, I want you to fail.
I've been talking ever since we talked about this race. I've been talking about how good I am at this game. How we're gonna eat my words.
Yeah, I'm gonna just go on ahead and start the flight myself. Because I need to stay close to this person as much as possible. I'm coming for you, Firecat.
I'm almost done. I need one more train.
Let's do this. Sunny flight. I actually failed the first time for this, so this is not my stronghold.
Yeah, I think Crystal Flight and Wob Flight, those are the two that I typically fail. I used to have the demo for this, and I think the stones would light up, you know, as you jumped on them, not after.
Okay.
That was kind of interesting. You can do the bosses when you want, though, but for some reason, in this game, you had to do a portal first, and the fight doesn't count.
I really am not doing good. Probably should have practiced.
So, let's go to Dark Hollow.
Yeah, it looks like I'm gonna fail this one. I don't think I have enough time.
You know, I kinda liked how they did it before. The way they did it in this game. In the third game, you don't get extra time when you hit stuff.
Yeah, that's true.
I like how you can get extra time. Oh, and Spyro has like a little flip move too, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Push the L1 and R2 buttons?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Maybe we can try that later.
Yeah. Once I catch up with you. Maybe I should try that right now. What is it? L...
Yeah, one turns around and the other just does a complete flip.
Fail.
Hey, you have a favorite music track?
I like the track from Blowheart.
Oh yeah, I like that one too.
That's one of my favorite ones. Blowheart is the boss, the first boss for this game.
No, that's Toasty.
Toasty?
Blowheart's the Twister.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I like him too, though. Yeah.
Some pretty fun bosses.
My favorite probably has to be Misty Block, not High Caves. Treetops is basically High Caves,
yeah,
but faster, like on steroids or something.
Yeah.
And if I can think of anything, maybe now and again I can chime in with some trivia.
That works for me.
I can try and think of some. Well, since we're on the subject of music,
mm-hmm.
You know that band, The Police?
Yeah.
The guy that composes music,
mm-hmm.
is their former drummer.
Oh, really?
His name is Stuart Copeland.
Yeah, I heard about him.
Yeah, he did the music for the Spyro Trilogy, and he did it for Enter the Dragonfly.
I always love his music.
Yeah, his music is awesome.
If only they were played in every single Spyro game.
I know!
I'd be hooked up on all of that.
Yeah, Legend of Spyro seems more, you know, more about atmosphere than, you know, tracks.
Did I just lose again?
Yeah, it took me forever to master the slides.
This stinks.
I try to go in a certain order. There's really no set order for slides or
just get rid of these blades in a timely order, then maybe I can do something. There we go.
I especially hated the planes.
Maybe they fly in a set order, but still. They get on my nerves. I gotta get those trains and get them after I run through these.
Now, if you're anything like a typical Spyro player, you probably won't want to do what I'm doing now, because I'm going to go after the boss.
You going to go after him right now?
Yeah. One thing you'll want to note about the boss, the first three, I believe, have no health, so you want to go there in full health.
Doing good for once.
Yay!
About time.
Another thing you don't want to do that I'm doing now, this.
Yeah.
I only do this because I'm being reckless. I'm probably going to get hurt. But you'll want to wait. See, you have to flame them once and they try to hit you. And then you flame them again.
That's perfect.
Don't do what I'm doing, please. I get pretty darn reckless.
Come on, treasure chest. Oh, man.
These dogs bigger than Spyro. Well, I mean, when they try to jump on you anyway.
Ah, I did not mean to do that. I passed it.
Yay!
About time. This is what I get for not practicing.
Well, don't worry, the first world's pretty easy, so I think you'll catch up pretty soon.
We'll see. Nah, I have hope back in it. I'm gonna just go to the next stage, and I'll get the other treasure later. And this treasure life. Time for some Spyro Spark action. Entering the Dark Hollow for me. I have no idea where you are. Oh right, you said you're at the first boss.
Yeah, I'm at the first boss. And I think people should do what you suggested earlier.
Getting the treasures first.
Yeah, go to the world first and then go for the portals. I only do this because I know where most of the stuff is. But yeah, you'll want to get everything in the world first. And I like to chase Toasty. I joked that one of the sheep couldn't take it anymore. They didn't like Spyro flaming them and getting their butterflies and stuff.
Yeah, that's what happened. It only took one world to put on to realize that, too.
Yeah, Insomniac seems to have this tradition where the first world enemies in the hub world don't do anything to you. They just run.
Yeah. If I go over here, if I go down here first, then I can skip all this stuff. Dang it! Yeah. Hate that bad. Turn around. Get blazed.
Take that!
Another one. I'll just get him later. I only got 3 dragons. Or 4. Bye.
Oh yeah, 5. Maybe I can show you something funny with Stony Hill. Something. I'm so silly. But I just... Okay, I don't get like a real kick out of it. I just think it's kind of, you know, funny.
Oh.
But when I saw it happen, it was... I just had to laugh.
What happened?
I'll show you at the end of the.
Okay.
Happy you, dragon.
And when I say that, you know, I don't mean like trying to distract you or anything. I'm just gonna say what it is. I don't want people to think I'm a cheater.
Oh. Finally. Oh, and if anybody is taxing, we're playing on an emulator right now.
Yeah. It took us forever to set up.
Don't tell them that. Okay. Don't tell them it took like 3 hours to do this. Actually, it took longer, but you know.
You know, I'm surprised Treetops got the most hatred, because... The only one I find harder than that is Twilight Harbor.
I didn't mind Twilight Harbor.
Really?
Mm-mm. Treetops, though, if you mess up one thing, you have to go back over and over again. And that's not what I want to do. Come on, get out of there, Darius. You die. I didn't kill him, did I?
You know what else I didn't like about this? If you're missing one gem, you have to go through the entire portal to find it.
Thanks for reminding me, I forgot that chest. Oh, I'll be over here.
You're welcome. I'm glad they gave Sparks that ability where he can, like, sense treasure. He can point to it.
He can do it in this game.
He can do it in this game, too?
Yeah.
Huh? No, were you asking or were you saying it?
No, exactly.
Oh, no, he can't do it, unfortunately.
I figure. He can only do it in Spyro 2 and Spyro 3.
Yeah, and in Spyro 3, it has to be unlocked. It's automatic in Spyro 2, so I don't know what went wrong with that.
Yeah.
Like, Insomniac wants to be cheap.
Good god, this took forever. Okay. Alright, I am going out. I'm going to this place all over. Stonehill.
Treasure.
Oh, I love this stage. Because I can ram this thing right over here, right now. I love doing that. I did that on a playthrough too. It was hilarious.
This little teeny dragon! But you can't do that to the boar! What gives?
Yeah, that's not fair. You can ram them and everything, but it just doesn't die. Mm-hmm. You gotta blaze it.
And it has wings.
Mm-hmm.
Or it has little wings. What's the point of that?
Yeah, they just look funny. That's the only option. That's the only thing.
I often miss gems in this one.
I think we all do.
Yeah.
Cause they hide really, really far away. This bit, really far. Hopefully. Do okay with this.
Okay, I got all of them. Now, let's see if I can try that thing. It has to do with these sheep.
Where are you? Oh, boy.
Right here.
There you go.
Joosh! No, I wanted to get all of you!
It feels a lot different when you're doing a speed run. You can't really focus on anything because you're racing.
Okay. Yeah, I can't get it. Come on.
Wee.
Okay. Let's see if I can get it to happen.
What you got to?
What?
Come on. Ugh, it's not doing it. There we go. Okay.
What happened?
I just thought that was so funny. I hope you could see that.
I didn't see anything. Oh, shoot, I got those terms.
Yeah, don't pay attention to my screen. I can show you that later. But, for the people watching, you know, it's really not funny at all. It's not that funny, but I just thought it was kind of funny.
I want to see something funny.
When you, you know how the little animals that give you butterflies return after a while? Like, if you go down a hill after killing all of the sheep in that area I was just in,
mm-hmm.
if you go down far enough and wait long enough, you can see the new sheep appear.
Oh.
It's kind of rare that you can see the animals just come back. You have to go a good distance away.
Wow.
These things just, it's like they just teleport there.
Dang.
And now it's Town Square, and I think a lot of people thought this was annoying too because of the thief.
Mm-hmm.
For a long time, I couldn't figure out how to get him.
He just goes everywhere. Alright, back to this place. Right here.
And the thieves are really pathetic in this game. Well, compared to Spyro 3 anyway.
Right.
Are you stuck? Aw.
Let me help you with that. Alright. Going up. Keep forgetting to skip these things.
Yeah, me too. Alright, let's see if I can make this. I want to try and get him in one shot. Got him!
Nice.
Yeah, once he gets away, you're pretty much done. You have to start over. I mean, not the portal. You have to take that glide again.
see, when he runs up here, he jumps down there. Right down there.
There you are, thief. Get real. Duh. Where are the last gens at? Brace yourself, YouTubers. This might take a while. Where are those last gens?
Temple. No!
Alright, go there.
Missed him!
Yes, I did. Huh? Alright, went there. There you are. Get them on.
Now, a lot of dragons give you tips, but a good number of them just say, "Thank you for releasing me."
That's their cliche, that's for sure.
And, you know, some of them you have to save twice. Because all the dragons from the final world, they're previously rescued dragons. Like, did you get captured again or something?
Yeah, I kind of got captured again. Could you help me?
And, you know, a lot of times they have, like, different voices.
Yeah. I don't see how that's even possible. If they went on a growth spurt or...
Yeah.
They were smoking on helium. I don't know.
I know for certain Clancy Brown plays one of them. And later on, it sounds nothing like him.
That's right. Where are the last two jobs? Why?
Let's see.
Where are you?
Probably want to kill enemies again, you know, if you end up back in a world, because they can give you lives and stuff.
Yeah. Oh yeah, if we somehow get a game over, the speedrun is done.
Okay.
That ain't happening though, because I'm not planning on dying. Pretty sure Firecat is not planning on that either. He's probably doing a heck of a lot better job than I am right now. Because I can't find a last gem. Did I miss an enemy or something? Or did I forget to drop down? And this is strange.
Good to be sure. Okay, world 2.
Yeah. Trying to be jealous. It'll be alright, Tumbler. Ah!
Yeah, you're Tumbler. You're supposed to be better than me. You can do the animal dash and whatnot.
Just wait till we start playing Tumba.
Yeah, you're gonna annihilate me on that.
We should have played that first. This is sad. I can't find a last two gems.
Hey, you know how I was telling you about the Japanese version earlier?
Yeah.
I think Sparks is green throughout the entire game.
Sparks is green?
He's green, but the glow around him is still yellow and blue. And you have to look at the glow, not the color he actually is.
Yeah.
I guess they changed that for the American version. Because he actually changed colors.
I like him golden better.
Yeah.
Now mine's just blue. And now it's golden. Help me find this gem, dang it. I wish they had that ability on this game. Wouldn't that be great?
Yes. It's like, you know, I was, I don't remember exactly when I heard this. But I did hear someone talk about, like, the Crash games, and, you know, how much better the sequels are.
Yeah.
And, you know, they were talking about how hard the first one is, and the first one is definitely hard. It is really hard compared to the other ones.
Yeah, I agree.
But, you know, they were making a point to say that, you know, there's nothing wrong with the game, really. It's just the sequels do so much better. So, you know... I don't really see anything, like, wrong there. With Spyro. It's just, Insomniac had so many better ideas that, you know, there's so much they could have done with this that they did with the sequels.
Yeah. But it was their first game, their first Crash Bandicoot game.
Yeah.
They kind of did the same thing with Spyro. You know, the hovering technique?
Yeah, the hover, the, he can swim, he can do the head bash.
He has all those abilities in Tumba. Excuse me. Spyro 2. Why did I just say Tumba?
Because you are Tumba.
Alright.
You love Tumba.
Oh.
So yeah, Spyro and Crash, you know, the earlier games, there's really nothing wrong. It's just, they did so much better later on. Insomniac and Naughty Dog did so much better with the later games.
Right. Oh boy, I gotta catch up.
No, don't worry, I'm in the second one. When I was a kid, I couldn't get out of the second world. I think my mom did it first. I got her into this game.
Oh.
My mom actually made it to Magic Crafters before I did. And I'm the one that taught her how to play the game. Like this glide, for example. I never knew about this glide. I think she discovered it first.
Oh yeah. Darn it. I don't know how I discovered that glide too. I must have just been playing around with it. Eventually, I knew where to glide because I was lost and I was like, where do I go? This way, that way. I can just glide anywhere, so let's just try it. And yeah.
Yeah, my mom probably saw that ledge.
Treasure, dragons.
She got the book at some point, the manual, but I don't remember when. Darn it! Step glide.
What happened? You died?
Nope. Oh, you so want that, don't you?
Yes, I do. Not that it matters. We have way too many lives to die and lose the game. I don't know how many lives I got.
Yeah, see, that's why I was recommending. If you go back to a hub world and you see the enemies, you're probably going to kill a lot of them again. Because they'll give you lives.
Yeah.
Or at least crystals for large.
Mm-hmm. How many crystals is it? 10, 12, 20?
Yeah, that much? I never actually counted. But yeah, just get enough. A lot of them just give you lives. Sometimes they don't even give you crystals. They give you lives, crystals, and sparks isn't glowing. They'll give you butterflies.
Okay.
And the thieves give you crystals too. If you kill them again.
Whoops. I'm not saving any right now. I'm going to ram you and then smoke you. And smoke you out too.
I think I saw a race like this online too. I remember it was a race, but I didn't watch it.
Only if I didn't lose so much in that speed run, I'd be right there. Alright, take one. Action. Ram. I'm probably going to ram all these D's just for the heck of it. Because I love ramming them.
Yeah,
so much fun.
So funny.
Yeah.
Are you
going to
ram the one that doesn't move?
I'm going to try. I always miss these things right here when I'm on the stage, because I always pass through it and chasing the thief along with
them. Aww.
But now noticing that, after all these years, I don't skip it anymore.
I hate when they put a chest that you have to charge into next to a cliff.
Yes.
Jeez.
I think that's the case on your stage right now. What stage is that?
Dry Can.
Yep. Like this is section where this, I think there's a metallic chest in like a lone pillar, whatever it's called.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have to charge it, and if you charge too fast, you'll just fall off the cliff. And that's not fun. Get out of the door. Okay, where do we go now? Here.
I think I messed up
my slide. I can't wait till I get to your stage. Actually, that stage was the longest I've, that took for me.
Hmm?
I think in that world, it took me a while to get to, that stage.
Dark Canyon?
Yeah. Do I have enough? Oops. get out of here. I think I did all the stages. I just need to find the gems in the world map and then kill... What's his name again? Lohar. Not Lohar.
Toasty.
Oh, there we are. Ah! Just looking for that treasure. I hate the glide. Hovering. I'll get used to it again. There we go. I think there's another one over here. Or shoot.
Take this! And this! Come back. Get all
of them. Forgive me, YouTubers. It took me a long time to get this. It's time to catch up with this kitty.
Hey, come back.
Dare you moon me?
Alright, Toasty. Time to get toasted. I have my own technique in defeating these dogs over here. Mm-hmm. You see where you can just roll left and right? Mm-hmm. I just roll to the left, burn them, roll again, and then burn them again.
That's a move they probably shouldn't have taken out. I don't know why they took it out of there.
Dang it! I failed. It worked before. I'm gonna make sure it works for now on.
I always forget that moves in the game.
Yeah, because the other ones.
My favorite game is Crypto's Rage. Probably why. I play that more often. Well, actually, lately I've been playing Spyro 3 more often.
I like Spyro 3.
Yeah, I really love. When I got these games, I couldn't stop playing them. I really loved Spyro 3.
I liked Spyro 2 because he had new abilities and all.
Yeah.
And he had new friends. That kind of took him out of his world, you know?
Yeah.
With the portal.
Yeah, kind of kidnapped him.
Yeah. Ow. Okay, I have no life. I really need to be careful here.
Probably wouldn't have a video game
if
Professor had intercepted one of the bigger dragons.
Mm-hmm.
That guy could probably just squash
Ripto
out.
Pretty much. You took the wrong dragon for this job. Well, they kind of picked right. Either way, Ripto would have been destroyed. He hates dragons after all, even though his name is...
Spyro!
Technically, yes. Spyro.
Spyro!
Who would have guessed?
Yeah, I never knew. When I heard that, I just had to look it up. Lo and behold, it actually looks like Ripto in English.
Yeah.
I mean, albeit a bit distorted, but, you know, that's what it looks like. Oh, I ran into
it. I gotta do all this without, sparks. Oh, no. Or I could just fall off the cliff. Yeah.
And how many lives you
got? We'll find out now. 7. Playing on losing.
See, there's another cheap move. They put some of these ladies next to cliffs, so when they smack it, you fall off.
So when was the last time you played Spyro the Dragon?
I think I played it the other day.
It's been months for me.
Yeah,
as you can tell.
I don't remember if I played this one recently, but I played Ripto's Rage, and I did the, you know that bomb challenge in Scorch?
Yeah.
I hate that challenge! I managed to do it without messing up the first time, but the second time I did it, I messed up. I heard some people were kind of creeped out by the way the flag people look. I guess it's the eyes.
Alright, I think I'm about ready to get out of this world and meet you up in...
Well, Peacekeeper.
Peacekeeper, yeah.
I don't get why these things lose their feathers when I charge them. I get when I claim them.
Yeah.
Do they shed feathers when they see me or something? Are they that scared?
That must be it. Marco! Get
me
out of here.
Oh my gosh, this dragon's name is Marco. They're both named Marco! That's flipping awesome!
Two Marcos in one world. I love this music. That's one thing I love, I appreciate about video games. The soundtrack.
Yeah, video game music.
Welcome.
And I like how Stuart Copeland put extra tracks in here, because if you sit in a world too long, I don't think the hub worlds do it, but the regular portals, they change tracks. You may have to play at least 2 or 3 times.
Yeah. Shoot that. You die. Alright, this time I'm just gonna collect everything and then go to the next place. I didn't do that the last time. I'm just gonna do it this time.
See, I'm a bad influence.
Haha, die. I'm destroying these things. Even little bunnies. Is that a bunny?
I don't know what that is. That thing hopping around.
Yeah.
Looks like I missed something.
Sometimes these things like to stick their butt out when they're hiding in here.
Yeah. Like the moon yet. Just
my kids have to be
after all.
I don't know. I'm still way behind you. Yeah, I think you already did the
Hi, Spyro. I only did one portal. Well, I'll finish this one after I find the last gem.
That last one took a long time. Whoops. Whoops. Please don't die. Okay.
Yeah, the portals get longer.
Longer. Joy.
Happy joy.
Oh man.
If you can't find a final gem and it's not in a chest, you can, you know, search throughout and find a sparkle. All the gems that aren't in chests, they all sparkle no matter how far away they are.
That's a good point. Change things around. I'm gonna do the speed run first.
So you're gonna do the flight?
Mm-hmm. Keep calling the speed run.
Well, let's call speedway later.
Yeah. Just to get out of the way, because I don't like this one, first of all. Oh. Hate this one. Hate losing to this one. Okay. Night flight, here we go. I always end up missing something.
Right now, I'm missing something. Ah, there we go!
Yeah, I think on my playthrough I was missing one of the chests or something. Your dad or misjumped it or something. It's been a while. So I didn't do that just now. Okay.
That's why I hate crystal flight.
Mm-hmm. And the flights in this game, if you fall in the water, of course, you have to restart it.
Yeah, you die.
It's like that on all of them, I believe, too.
Yeah, later on, he just... What, does he slap the water or something because he lost?
Yep.
Can't touch the water at all.
Not even your wings touch it. I don't know about that, but... I ain't testing it now. Oh, I remember these things.
No, I'm going to Ice Caver now, and the way I play this one might seem kind of odd, but you know, it's the way I've been doing it for a long time. Yeah, I only do it because, well, I'm going to show you right now. Wait a minute, wait, let me get this one. Here's why I do it. I do it backwards. Yeah, I like to play Ice Caver backwards because of this right here. Three lives here.
Oh. I think I missed that on my playthrough.
Yeah. I never knew how to get that.
Probably want to skip it just for time reasons.
There's no way to get back after you do that. That's why you have to do it backwards if you do it first.
Okay.
And this music used to creep the heck out of me.
I kind of like the music.
Yeah, I like it now. I was scared of this.
Oh, man.
Oh, miss me! That guy almost hit me. Snowball. But weird, a snowball can do you damage. And in the second game, there's a fish that squirts water on you and it does damage.
Oh, yeah.
Does that make any sense?
No. No, it doesn't.
Especially since he can swim in that game.
Yeah. This is a little Splash. Magic Art Splash. Reference.
And this guy on the skis. He's so fast. He's on skis. Why is he fast?
I think I do remember myself losing in one of those in the, oops. I need to stop doing that. I need to, I lost against one of those ski monsters in... I can't remember, but I think you, you're not there right now. I'll show you when you get there.
Okay.
Can't remember if it had spikes right there, but... Either spikes or...
Oh, you can skip the egg spinning around and press the start button.
Huh? Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, I ran every single of these so far. That's gonna be the trend, everybody. I'm not sure what Firecat's been doing. I'm assuming she's been blazing them all. Ah, I'm gonna die.
Well, I rammed into one.
Help me! Help! Well, that's my first death. Surprise.
No, it's not. Remember?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, the other one was on purpose.
Yeah, just so I can get sparks back. Okay, I died twice. They were not penalizing for deaths, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was telling you, take advantage of lives when you find them.
Yeah.
When you get to Ice Caver and... try and make that glide because it's worth getting those three lives.
Yeah, do that. What are these things? Are they kangaroos? Or deer? They look stupid.
Maybe they're hares.
Oh, yeah. Alright, let's do this. Dry Canyon!
No, I found this really funny racing game. It was supposed to be a launch title for the PlayStation 1. And, you can fight other players, you know, knock them off their boards and stuff. It's like, I forget the exact name, but it's one of those, like, extreme sports type games.
Okay.
And it's really hilarious. There's a rabbit and a hen that you can run over.
Yeah.
I think if you run over the rabbit, you can
you would... I think you get thrown off your board or something.
Oh, dang.
But if you run into the hen, it just makes this weird noise. Like, it's so funny.
Remember that technique that you used to do?
Oh,
you did it on a treasure, yeah.
Yeah.
If you do this 3 times, that enemy up there will just die.
Yeah, I did that.
I didn't even see that. Yeah.
I always do that because it's so funny.
I figured that out a few months ago when I replayed this game.
I tried to do that with one of the bulls, and it's really tricky because the bull won't stop moving.
Yeah. Another thing to ram. Die.
But you know what?
Yeah.
There's a thief in High Cage that you can do that to. If you don't make a move, you could probably get him one more shot.
Oh, nice.
Because I think there's 3 propellers next to him. You could probably get him with the first one if you don't make a move.
Okay. Let me get that dragon. Hey, Conan, bye, Conan.
I did a separate video with the music for this. I waited, like, I don't know how many minutes to jump on a completely different track. Oh, actually, the track, you remember the track for the 5th boss? Jock.
What?
Is that how you say it? Jock?
Jock.
He's basically a jack in the box or something.
Oh, I remember now.
Yeah, that, there's the track that comes on after the music stops. Apparently in Europe, that track is the one for High Caves. So if you wait, for the track to loop, I guess, twice, the new track that comes on, that's the track for High Caves in the European version.
Oh, that's interesting.
So, I don't know why they changed it for the American version. It's kind of odd, but, you know, I'm just glad it's in both versions.
Yeah.
Oh, crap. Okay, here's my first death.
Oh.
The rest of that glory.
Falling off the cliff. Classic. Right now, it's a thunderstorm outside, so if y'all hear any thundering and stuff, that's going out there.
Yep, just a storm.
Yeah, this is gonna blow by. Or not, knock the power out. That would suck.
It was raining really hard earlier. It's not really raining much now.
Mm-hmm.
It's like 4:30 p.m. and it's really dark.
Yeah. Scary.
Okay, I'm gonna take the same route that my cousin took and do the flight.
Oh, right. This is my cousin, Firecat.
I guess we should have mentioned that in the beginning. We're cousins.
Yeah. She's actually one of the people a long time ago that got me hooked in the spiral.
Oh, yeah. And you got me into Chipotle.
Yeah.
And I think Frogger.
That's right. I love those games. I also have a playthrough on my places lists in case y'all want to look at that. They're really old, but they're pretty decent. I did a good job, right? Right?
Yeah, I did Kimba a long time ago, too.
Oh, okay.
I don't remember how well I did. Oh, you know, there was a part in there that someone found really annoying, and I managed to kind of master it. Probably can't do it now. I like to come in there from behind, by the way. I don't know why. Well, I know why. I just remember why. The enemy, if you don't kill him, he just dies instantly. It's just a gem there. If you come out. I was always confused by that arrow there. At first, when you see that fairy.
Oh, yeah. That's probably how I lost.
Yeah. I guess their logic is that since her back is to you, you're not supposed to follow her.
Then I ended up missing the lighthouse.
Oh, yeah.
went from chest.
And when I skipped there, it saved me like 10 seconds worth of time, which is really good. Good advice, don't follow the fairy.
Yeah, don't follow that first fairy. Crap! That's why people hate this flight.
I know I hate it.
And I said crystal fog was my worst one, but I'll probably do that in one shot.
Usually after the night flight, everything goes very well with flights. Like, we know what we're doing.
Except with wild flight. That's one that I tend to do a lot.
I think I mastered that the first time I did it.
Oh, wow.
Lucky me. Lucky me. Okay, I better not miss this flight. Or... make it. Make it. Okay. Dry Canyon, I usually do miss this cliff flight, which really, really stinks. And then I go back to the last dragon that I see, which was probably usually far, but this time it's closer. Either way, I think I am clear at this stage. I am missing 6 gems.
Oh.
Dang it!
One more.
You can do it. I better start paying attention to my own screen. I almost fell off the cliff.
Only took 2 tries, yes.
Good job. You're still ahead of me. No.
See, that thing just died. There's just a gem there. let's tackle the boss. And you know what? I'm being even more of a daredevil because I'm not in full health. Got blue sparks. Ooh, maybe I can show you something else funny.
What?
It's not really funny, it's just, it's kind of interesting.
There
hopefully
you are.
Get it to work.
I can't believe I missed this one up here. Ah, I need help.
You know what's really weird about Nasty's loot?
Mm-hmm.
I got the manual. The thieves in treetops are supposed to be, I think, green and purple. The other one, the one looks clearly red, right?
Yeah.
But there's purple thieves in Nessie's loop, and I'm wondering what they're supposed to be.
Yeah. I find that strange, too. Okay.
Messed up this one last time I played.
Hopefully
I can make it.
Get some help. Killing these things, I don't know.
Kangaroos,
hares.
Okay, yeah, it worked. Now, here's the thing I thought was interesting. These enemies here, if you shoot the lady first before she can hit them, they just stay here. They don't run. If you get close enough, it doesn't try to strike you.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought that was really weird, because you know, the idea is that their faces are covered, and that's why they run off the cliff.
Yeah.
But they're always facing you no matter where you are on the level. So, yeah, it's kind of weird.